Hello, and in this video, we're going to be having a look at Ramshackle Games as a model alternative to Games Workshop. Mainly specifically, since they're looking at military, Imperial Guard, the Astra Militarum. Wonder where they got that name from. Space Army, anyway. So before we begin, if you'd like to see more videos like this one, please hit the subscribe button and destroy the bell button so that you never miss an upload. We'll be doing a bit of back and forth, maybe going to Games Workshop's website and going back and forth from the Ramshackle Games, but I'm just proposing that this could be a cheaper option if you're wanting to fill out your Guard army, or possibly Renegade Guard, or Chaos Cultist even, to be fair. So what we've done, what my favourite thing to do is go lowest to highest. Ooh. Don't know if I've already said it. If you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button and destroy the bell button so that you never miss an upload. Yeah. So the first thing on here is a sergeant for £4. So what I should note, if we have a little scroll down, I think it does say that it also includes delivery. Yes, is Ramshackle Games orders include free worldwide shipping. So if you live in America, it's going to be free. If you live in Japan, it's going to be free to deliver. £4 includes the delivery. So if you compare that to other companies, usually within Britain, it's usually about £3 or £4 for delivery for anything, flat rate. So basically, if you get this dude, you pretty much get him for free, and the delivery is already included. So what you get with this guy for £4 is a very simple to put together model with what looks like an equivalent to a bolt pistol or a plasma pistol. He seems to be holding either a power sword or a chainsaw, but either way you could play it as either. You do get choices of heads, so as you can see there, he's with no head on. This one is the one with the Iron Brotherhood head, which is a decent head to be fair. This is a little selection of some of the tanks that you can get with them, which you can buy, and the globe. I want to say it's not a globe head, but basically it's like these space helmet kind of thing. So you can see what they look like painted differently. I believe these are put on metal discs, which are like washers, which kind of works because of the way that the base is. You could definitely put them on washers, save some money. You could buy some 25mm bases, not the end of the world. It's a representation of this guy within a unit of men. So basically, we'll move on from here, but that was £4. I think the best part, which we'll look at shortly, so we'll come back to these guys, is probably, I'm not keen on the pug trooper things, however, different folks, different strokes, is mainly, it's going to be these guys, so the Iron Brotherhood 10-man unit. So £10 for 10 models. It's a pound a model, right? So you want 100 models, you spend £100. It's as cut and dry as that one. So my opinion is this guy right here could be a proxy model for your sergeant because of the fact that he's waving his hand. He stands out from the others. You could paint him differently. Could be this guy with his hand on his hip. But principally, you could paint him slightly different with a helmet to denote some form of sergeant. So you wouldn't necessarily have to buy the sergeant model. It would be cool to have one in everyone. So effectively, what you'd have is you'd spend £14 for a unit where you could have 10 gunners or 9 gunners and 1 sergeant. and obviously what you could do though, if you bought the sergeant model, so the one with the arm there, you could replace his gun with a plasma pistol or a bolt pistol, and therefore you have 2 sergeants for the price of 1. Always good. Just one way around it. Again, £14. So we'll have a quick look in more in depth with these guys. So this is them with the Iron Brotherhood head, with what looks like bolt gun equivalents, but they could obviously be las guns. And I think in a minute we're going to see a direct comparison between the Games Workshop ones. So this are the different choices of heads. Go away. I do not want to do that, Google. Iron Skull, Neo Reich, Illustrious Third, the Iron Brothers, Chem Filters, which will be good for Chaos Cultists, and or the Savalar Chem Dogs, which would be a really cool army to do, I think. Plumed Helmets, just a really cool way to do it. And the Hooded Bionic, which is going to be a lot like Skitarii. but not dead on, and the bassinet, which looks a little Darth Vader-y. I mean, I'm sure some more history buffs will probably say it's actually like this model. Here we go. The aforementioned scale shot. Let's see. So it's a scale shot with Games Workshop model used without permission. So you can see immediately the model size. Obviously, he's standing on a little bit of a thing, right? So he's got a tiny bit of a height advantage, but I think the height advantage is basically that little mini base, which you could clip off. You could definitely leave on. I want to get rid of this Google junk. Go away. Right, thank you. Yeah. And the las gun is pretty much very similarly sized to the bolt gun equivalent. So my opinion is you could play them as guardsmen. So the other thing I was going to say about them, with the whole setup of them being 10 dudes with guns, is that they would definitely double for auto gun cultists. And these are with, I believe, the Reebok Assault vehicle. So I have one of these, and I've probably featured it in a couple of videos, and it definitely will be featuring in another video shortly. So I have acquired myself a Goliath rock grinder slash truck, and I'm going to do a size comparison between the two, as I think it'd be really helpful, especially if it is roughly the same size. They have a very similar aesthetic, so it is kind of cool. Hopefully it'll be a good video. Who knows, I might be calling it before it happens, but you can see what they look like, and that is basically like the Reebok tank but with a turret on the top. So it's a lot like Lehman Russ, so we can already see immediately, I believe that's why he did it. I think he built them together for purposes to show his basically Google. Sorry about this. For his own guard army. So what I'm going to do now, really quickly, I think if I've been sensible. Yes, I have. We're going to the Cadian ones. So Cadians, probably the best comparison. So now, they are currently £20, English pounds, right? For a 10-man unit. So I'm definitely not going to slate them. I do love Cadians. I have got a good ton of them. Luckily, I got them when there was a tiny bit wee cheaper. So the thing with these guys is, what you do get is you get the ability to build them in many different ways. The advantage is you can swap a torso for another torso. You can put different arms on different arms. So that's one of the negatives of the Ramshackle games, is that these guys, you have a lot more choice. They are very detailed. There's definitely no lack of detail on these guys. You can build a sergeant from this squad. You could build two sergeants, two grenade launchers, two flamers, two vox casters, or the equivalent. And you can build as many las gunners as you want. So you could build them all las gunners or all things. So that is, it's a really good kit. And I think it was actually a lot better when it was cheaper, like many things. But it's still a good kit. Whether it's worth £20, I'm not sure. That's not for me to say. I'm just glad I got all mine before they became £20. And this is a good thingy of the quality of the kit. It's really good. Some really good close-up pictures. Obviously, someone's painted these. Cadian Sergeant Steel. So if you are watching this video, if you know him, big shout-out to him. Cool. I like that. I never paint eyes because I can never do them right, but I like this guy's eyes. So yeah, some more pictures of what other people have done. So it is a really good kit. I'm definitely not slating it. But £20, if you wanted to buy 100 guardsmen, let's do your maths now, Nick. You'd have to spend £200 versus you could spend £10. So £100, you could get the same amount for half the price. Just consider that. If you don't worry about playing in Games Workshop themselves. So I'm going to go over some other units. I'm a bit concerned this video might go on a bit long. So I personally don't like these guys. I don't think they're terrible. But it would have been cool if you could swap the other arm out. But I won't go into them today. But there is another way. It's another way of doing it. £10 for 10 men. Always good. These guys, I think, are cool. I think these guys are like an equivalent to your Tempestus signs, with the fact that they've got a tube coming from their thingamabob, which is obviously, sounds like a doctor might need to be involved with that. A Tempestus signs. Wow, everything's gone up since I last look. Sorry about this, guys. A bit shocked. But £22.50. Wow, so that's quite a lot of money. And if we literally, so, right, obviously, again, let's have a quick look at this unit. Do love this unit. Cool weapon options, loads of choice. Cannot fault it on the amount of choice and the beauty of the model. There's a reason Games Workshop do very well, and it's because they make good models. I don't think anyone is really, well, with the exception of maybe Kirioth making his second video about the lack, about trying to, the worst models in the world. However, most of these are really good, and there's a ton of choice. You can build them however you want. Loads of equipment choices. Awesome models. However, with a current price increase of £22.50, I can't remember if they used to be £18, these guys are quite expensive. So we'll have a look at the other one. Just here. I'm not saying they're definitely going to be exactly the same, but as you can see on here, right, so they've all got the wire going from the gun, which I think looks more like a shotgun in my opinion, but you could definitely proxy them as hotshot las guns. They don't have to have the mole man head. You get at least one heavy weapon and one sergeant looking dude. So no close combat weapons there, but not a big deal. Let's have a look at them in more individually. Yeah, so this guy is the weapons guy. Looks like he's got a plasma cannon, plasma gun. What looks like a heavy stubber or a, maybe even like a heavy laser thing. Flamer and a minigun. So it's kind of cool. So these would be really good, again, for maybe like an enforcer, you know, for Renegade Guard. These are the weapon options, or some weapon options, I guess. Yeah, so these are the ones that are going to sit on your... You big heavy weapons guy. Let's have another look. Let's have a look at them without a background. Yeah, here you go. So I'm guessing your sergeant guy can have a different weapon as well, instead of that bit. But I think personally, they're not awesome. They're not, I actually think they're pretty good, to be honest, but I don't think they're as good. Go away, Google. I don't think they're as good as the Scions. However, again, they are good, and I think what we're coming back to is £12 for a 6-man unit, or £22, £10 more to have one less model. If you're trying to fill out the army, you want to test them, you want to have a cheap little setup army before you delve into 40 into Games Workshop Astro Militarum, this is a good little choice in my opinion. There is another thing I wanted to show you, at least one thing, which is, so some of these are a bit kooky, but cool, my opinion. I don't think you could use that as guard, apart from maybe as a sentinel proxy, but I don't think it works quite as good. It's this one here, basically. Wow, so I think it was 20, no, it has been £18, so £18, right? Maths is really not my strong point, so if someone wants to put it down below, if you wanted 100 of these guys, right, I don't think I can do it in my head, because I'm so terrible at maths, right? So it'd be like £72. My maths is bad, so correct me in the comments down below. If you wanted 100 guardsmen and you wanted to buy this, you buy it 5 times, that's right. No, it wouldn't be 72, would it? It'd be more like 80-something. Basically, you could spend £80-odd for 100 guardsmen or chaos cultists with guns, and you could buy this 5 times, and you'd have your delivery included. You can, again, as you say, as it says here, right? Please specify which heads you would like in the, let me know what you'd like by using the contact us page. If you've not specified, you will see the Iron Brothers heads. So we'll go and have a look at the heads. Oh, in fact, we've already looked at them. This is exactly a carbon copy of the other one, except it's 20 man squad. So you could literally buy this and the 10 man one for £28 off 30 dudes, or you could have, thanks guys, Prime War Games, shout out there, Facebook. Anyway, we'll have a look at some of the vehicles. Again, they're not an exact match. So as we're going up in price, this is the Reebok APC. It is pretty similar sized to a Chimera. It's between a Chimera and a Lehman Russ. So you could definitely double it as both. And so I'm not keen on these things. But again, different folks, different strokes. The pug, the gun flat cannon. Again, I think the weapon on the back, which you, so again, this is another thing you can buy separately. You don't have to buy the wagon, so you could buy the Reebok, and you could wham that on the back. for the gun, and you could have a Hydra relatively on the cheap. And obviously here we got the Battle Cat, which is basically the same base, so the Reebok tank, with a different little front guard on, and a massive turret, so it looks like a Lehman Russ. Oh, so we've missed out on loads of tanks here. Sorry, guys. yeah, so there's the wheeled one and the Reebok one. So depends what you're going for. But I think both work, to be fair. We'll have a quick... Yeah, again, I'm not keen on the pug things. It's you know, different people and all that. But you could definitely build a thing. So what we'll do real quick is just check the price of a Lehman Russ, because I actually can't remember what the price is at the minute, especially with the changes. So it could actually be quite expensive. So view all, that's always the best way to go around it. Lehman Russ, there we go. Wow, $32.50. That's the Demolisher, though, so let's be fair. I think the other one was slightly cheaper, if I recall. Sorry about this, guys. If I had any sense, I'd pause it, but I don't have any sense. I don't think they have an equivalent of a Bane Blade at the minute. I might be wrong. I don't know, £32. £32.50 for a Lehman Russ Battle Tank. So... you could get something and save £5.50, and you'd get delivery included. Now, obviously, there's other ways to save on Games Workshop. You can definitely go and get like 25% off at Triple Helix. You can go to like Goblin Gaming. You can go to your local shop, and I've already said this before, and it might change now, the rule. So the rule is, if you're spending £25 or less, definitely go to your local shops, because every time you're going to save money on your delivery cost of everywhere you go into. That's just my opinion, but you can check it out. It might have gone up because obviously Games Workshop have put the price of everything up. Yeah, so I suppose the principle of it is you could definitely use these guys. So the way I would suggest it is I'd probably use the guy, the sergeant-looking dude, this one, as your sergeant. I'd probably buy one sergeant, and for every two units that you buy, you'd probably get I'd get a sergeant. Because you're going to get an extra mod. Oh, sorry. I do apologize. There is some other ways to save money. So command team, this is pretty much a good way. So you've got like a what looks like a medic. So you'd be part of your company command squad. You've got what looks like a mechanic. He's got like a spanner in his hand, and then a dramatic pose guard dude. The special weapon squad. We'll have a quick look at that. £6, three models. One strength that you get with the Cadian squad is that they already have the weapons involved in them. So let's assume that you bought one sergeant, you bought one of these guys, and you bought a 10-man squad. You would then be up to £20. However, you would have another four models on top of that. And if you bought this, if you bought what we've just discussed and maybe another 10-man squad, another 20-man squad, you can definitely fill them out more and faster. So it is cheaper either way. However, let's have a quick look. So what do you get? You get a fusion blaster, which is, in my opinion, looks like some form of machine gun. You've got what looks like a plasma blaster. Looks a bit like a plasma gun. And evidently, the flamethrower. So these guys are slightly different in that they've got some form of backpack. Oh, looks like they've got a bigger back, I'm assuming, to hold ammunition. And again, you get the same choice of heads. They are quite big weapons, but I think it kind of works too. You could proxy them as anything you want. So you don't have to buy these. You could just have your standard las gunners. Cheapest way to use these, go away, is to use the just use the main guardsman, to be honest. There is another way. Another thing I did want to discuss super quick is the heavy weapons teams. I think the heavy weapons teams are really cool. So you could have... We'll look at one or two of them. The missile launch team, £8 for six models, basically gives you heavy weapons team for £8. Mortar unit, again, it's the same thing. You get copies, but you get £8 for three teams. And the same with the heavy weapons. So we'll have a look at this one specifically, because this one is really cool, in my opinion. You can either have them sitting down, like this one. So it's actually on a bit like a I can't remember what you call them. But it's a lot like the old school guard models. If you have any las cannons from Mordians or anything, they look very, very similar. So we'll have a quick look because there's some other pictures to look at. Here's one. Unassembled. So you get the wheels, you get the main base, and then you get the weapons. So it's what looks like a heavy bolter, a las cannon for definite, and maybe an auto cannon, and I don't know what the other one is. But you can definitely play them as either. And you get a loader and another guy. So what you get is, let's have a quick look. I think you can also order them. We've already got the guy made attached to them. So these would be really cool if you're getting the other ones. If you get this one, is you could definitely just put some Cadians next to it. So you could buy a normal squad of Cadians, or you could buy a normal squad of these guys, to be fair. But if you want to just use the heavy weapons base, you could use this as a heavy way to get more heavy weapons cheaper. For £8, you get the weapons and you just buy some bases. It, in my opinion, it's really cool. But obviously, again, different people may hate them. We'll have a quick look at the missile launcher. Yeah, we'll go with the missile launcher. I don't think there's many pictures on this one, but this is what you get. You get a loader and you get a missile launcher guy. Pretty simple. But again, £8. We'll have a quick glance and see how expensive the heavy weapons team is for Games Workshop. Again, one added bonus of the Games Workshop heavy weapons team is that you get everything. So if you want to build one mortar, one missile launcher, one heavy bolter, or one autocannon, so three models, three thingies, you get to build it either way. But you can build them any way you want. They come with the bases, always good, and there's a lot of choice and style on the models. However, £25, with the other ones, you could buy three sets for the price of one on these. So you could definitely fill out a little squad, a little platoon, however you want to call it, for basically for the price of one. So one day I might sit down and work out the price of going to Ramshackle Games and building a detachment for on the cheap for guardsmen and with heavy weapons, with special weapons, with sergeants, with as many lasguns as we can possibly throw at it. The problems may be when it comes to like sentinels and stuff like that, which you're not going to get a direct match. But assuming you use these guys as chimeras, you could definitely build them any way you want. I feel like now I'm kind of going off on a tangent, and the video, thanks James, has been going on for a little while. So I'm going to call it here, guys. Again, massive disclaimer. I'm not saying that these models are better than Games Workshop. They are different, but they are similar. It's like apples and oranges. Everyone loves apples, everyone loves oranges. They're different tastes, but they do the same job, relatively speaking. Now, obviously, that's an oversimplification. Anyway, so I'd like to know your comments down below if you've got an even better example of how to save money with Guardsmen and using proxies, Ramshackle Games. Let me know. I'm going to make another video with other models included. So as ever, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.